Hi there, I'm Dokus, and today we'll get you started with your ATOS Q. In this tutorial, I'll teach you how you can use the touch probe. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. Until now, we always digitized parts, but we can actually add points with a touch probe. A touch probe is a predefined set of reference points with a glass tip. Both are related to each other. A touch probe can be combined together with the scan data to add several measurements or to reach difficult to scan areas. Here you can see that I've prepared a project already with some scan data inside, so the reference points are already measured. If I switch to the live workspace, I have the possibility to add touch probe measurements. Let's say, for example, that I would like to add the diameter or the measurement of this cylinder below. It's not so easy to reach because it's an undercut of the rest of the part. If I select the touch probe, I can choose which element I would like to measure. In our case, it's a cylinder. I can use the remote control to capture points. All these points will be combined to make a fitting cylinder. I position the touch probe in front of the sensor and I can start measuring. When enough points are measured, our cylinder appears in the software. You can see here that I have no scan data, but the cylinder is actually measured. This is thanks to our touch probe. Another thing we can do with the touch probe is use it for guided touch probe measurements. To do this, I prepared another project. Here you can see a cut file where I already defined a cylinder. This cylinder I would like to measure. I can switch over to the digitizing workspace, release the sensor, and start with our first scan as usual. As we know, automatically the table and the background are recognized, so are cut off from our measurement. Because we already made a pre-alignment and defined the cylinder, everything will be calculated automatically. This means that you can now immediately measure the part which we want to measure. If I switch over to our live workspace, I can again go to my touch probe. Here I now have the possibility to work with a guided touch probe measurement. I can now take the touch probe and move over to the cylinder I would like to measure. As soon as I'm near the cylinder, the software will automatically identify which cylinder this is. Now I can start measuring. When the measurement is done, I can finish the measurement. Again here, thanks to the parametrics of the software, everything is calculated already. I see my nominal value, my actual value, and the deviation. This means that I can prepare a complete measuring plan and, with the help of the software, automatically measure everything that I want to. If you experience anything different from what you have seen here, or if you have any issues with your ATOS Q, please reach out to us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more getting started information, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, I will see you next time.